personal performance in the coming year. I also commend the sterling contributions of all personnel on diplomatic missions, personnel that has seconded to regional and international organizations and friendly African countries in the quest for global peace and security. Our team for this 9 lessons and carols could not have been more appropriate than this. I quote, "Behold, the Savior is born," unquote. We have every reason to praise the Lord because in spite of our limited resources, the Lord has seen us through to accomplish great success in this passing year in terms of security, both internal and external. And it is because we have a Savior. Let every Ghanaian, and for that matter, every soldier, look up to the Savior who, through his divine power on our side, will complement our human efforts to achieve greater heights. In this direction, command will request the Director of Religious Affairs to uplift us all before God daily and ask him to empower us to do what is right in spite of our challenges. Let us maintain our resolve to protect our unity of purpose, our collective will and determination to succeed in our efforts to maintain the integrity of our homeland Ghana as our government strives to meet our logistical and personnel requirements. May we praise and we say, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I thank you very much. Let me take this opportunity to express our gratitude as Ghana Armed Forces and on my own behalf to the Ghana Broadcasting Corporation for deciding to collaborate with us to celebrate this all-important occasion. It is imperative to note that the two bodies have been working together for so many years for the promotion of peace and stability of our nation. For this and many other reasons, I want to thank the board and the management of GBC and the organizers of this great program for this wonderful collaboration. This is a practical demonstration of civil-military cooperation. I therefore urge both organizations to nurture and sustain this collaboration to the benefit of our nation. And I wish to extend my warmest felicitations and best wishes of joy, peace, and goodwill to all ranks, civilian employees, our families, and all gathered here this evening. I wish to commend you all for your loyalty, vigilance, integrity, dedication to duty, and professionalism that has enabled us to maintain the much needed peace and security for our nation. As you know, there can be no sustainable development without peace and security. And we must all, therefore, take pride in our individual and collective roles towards the peace and security of our nation. That is a sure way to guarantee the development of the nation which we all yearn for. I expect that we will maintain our positive attributes to enable us to discharge our duties professionally and efficiently to our country and to our God. We are well aware of the emerging security threats from the Sahel region and in our maritime space. The military high command, with the support of government, has put in the necessary measures in training and acquisition of critical platforms and equipment to forestall any security breaches. We therefore, as a collective, need to be extra vigilant in providing the needed security to safeguard the territorial integrity of our country. During the year under review, we witnessed the completion of some old projects and the beginning of new ones, which were designed to enhance the operational capabilities and welfare of our personnel. Significant among these projects are troops accommodation in all garrisons. Of particular note are mine quick impact projects across all garrisons, which are aimed to alleviate some of the infrastructural and logistics challenges of our units. On the international front, we have been able to maintain our good image and high respect in the various peace support operations where we operate, be it in Lebanon, Mali, South Sudan, the Gambia, Central African Republic, and Western Sahara, through our discipline, dedication, and professional pursuit.
is once again being brought to us by the kind courtesy of the Garrison Methodist Presbyterian Church, Denmark, Accra, Promasido Ghana Limited, and Kabru Limited, key distributors of unnatural mineral water.